and welcome to Boston's very own Dash Radio Hour. My name is Veronica Day, and I am, as you know, your host tonight and every Saturday night from 7 p.m. to 8 p.m. while we spend an hour together. I know it's been hard with our men away, but us girls have put together quite a show for y'all. This evening, like we do every Saturday evening, we'll be joined by my friends, the Baylor Sisters, Marilyn, Carolyn, and Sarah Lynn, and our incredible troupe of actors from the Dash Vaudeville Troupe. Tonight, they'll perform a spooky tale for you called Early Frost, written by a very talented writer named Douglass Parkhirst. When they come out later, I'll introduce each one of them to you, but I know our regular listeners know each one of them by name and by voice. And as always, my talented team is here in the studio bringing you all the sounds you love to hear. Evelyn Hawks and Hazel Pruitt. Let's hear from you, ladies. Perfect. We are so lucky to have such a talented group of women for our show tonight. And now, let's begin with a word from our sponsor, Bristan Cold Medicine, from our lovely Baylor Sisters.
Achoo! Mommy, I don't feel so well.
What's wrong, honey?
My nose is all snuffed up, and my throat is sore, and I just feel crummy.
I have just the thing for that. Here, Jane, Tristan works on sinus congestion and helps drain all 8 cold cavities. There's nothing like Tristan congestion tablets. Just put one under your tongue and let it dissolve.
Mmm! Thanks, Mommy. It tastes like cherries. I can tell it's gonna work fast.
Jane is right. It will work fast. That's because for the first time ever, Dristan makes it possible to unite certain medically proven ingredients into one fast-acting uncoated tablet.
How do you feel, Jane?
I feel better already, thanks to Dristan.
That's right, ladies. Dristan Cold Medicine, a great sponsor for Dash Radio Hour. And now let's hear a bit about Kirkman Borax Soap.
Barb, how did you get Jim's colors so white and fresh?
Aren't they great? He worked so hard, and they were looking so grimy. I was afraid I was going to have to throw those shirts out. Nothing I was doing was working.
Please tell us. I've tried lemons, baking soda, even bleach. I've ruined 3 of Jack's shirts in a row trying my mother's old remedies, and Jack snapped his cap with me when he saw he had to buy new ones. But the collars were all yellow. I was just trying to help.
My secret is Kirkman Borax Soap.
A bar of soap?
A bar of soap got the collar that clean?
It did. I can buy Kirkman Borax Soap as a bar of soap, but I can also buy it as a detergent and soak Jim's clothes overnight. It got out the sweat stains from his underarms, the ring around the collar, and even the grease stains from the coveralls he wears to work on the car.
It sounds like a miracle soap.
It sure does.
Kirkman Borax Soap really is heaven's little secret.
Kirkman Borax Soap sounds like a godsend. Thanks, ladies. You sure sound great today. How are y'all tonight?
We are just dandy, Veronica.
Oh, yes. We are just tickled to be on the show tonight. Aren't we, Marilyn?
Oh, yes, Carolyn. It's such a joy to be here, especially with my sisters.
Well, that's just swell. Thanks, girls. We'll see you back here in just a bit. Now it's time to introduce our Dash Vaudeville troupe and hear tonight's scheduled program, Early Frost, featuring the vocal talent of 6 very impressive ladies. Come on down, you talented troupe.
Hiya, Veronica. It's great to be here tonight.
Hi there, Cora. Welcome back to the Dash Radio Hour. We are so glad to have you and the girls here this week. I hear this show is a real doozy, and I am just tickled that it's a spooky one. I know our listeners are just going to think it's the bee's knees. Are you ready to introduce the program and get things rolling for us?
I sure am. I will be serving as the narrator, and I will make sure you meet all members of the troupe. And Evelyn and Hazel over there will give you all the right sounds to add to our story, just like they do every week. We had a gas working on this week's program to make sure it would be killer diller for all our listeners.
Sounds great, Cora. Have at it.
The Dash Vaudeville Troupe presents Early Frost, a one-act drama by Douglass Parkhirst. Our program features Betty Sue Johnson as Mrs. Clayton, a young and sympathetic social worker. Frances Buck plays Louise, a warm, pleasant woman of 60. Babs Bennett plays Hannah, her somewhat older sister. She is not obviously mad, but there is a wildness to her appearance and eyes, and she wears old-fashioned clothes, long, tight sleeves, high collars. Shirley Connolly plays Alice, a pretty girl of 12. Virginia James plays Lydia, a fragile, very pale, extremely pretty girl of 12. She is dressed in clothes of 50 years ago and wears a large hair ribbon tied in a bow on top of her head. Our time is the present. We're in a gloomy, shadowy attic, piled high with boxes, trunks, toys, old furniture, a child's slate, a spinning wheel, among other things. Dust and cobwebs cover everything. There is a large wooden chest in clear view through the jumble. On one wall, a small window provides the only light. On another, a narrow opening gives way to a dark stairwell. In all the store of yesterday's treasures and faded memories, nothing has been moved, apparently, for many, many years.
Careful now, don't slip!
My, these stairs are treacherous. Ah, here we are.
Louise enters carrying a flashlight. With her are Alice and Mrs. Clayton. Among them, they carry a collection of mops, buckets, and rags.
Goodness, it's dark up here.
Yes, the only light comes from that one little window. Now be careful you don't trip over anything. Heaven knows there's plenty to trip over.
Louise turns on the flashlight and shines it on the ceiling.
Now, let's see. That leak must be right over here someplace.
Eee! What's that?
Oh, it's just an old footstool.
I thought it was a mouse.
Good heavens, Alice! Don't even say that word!
There it is. See? Oh dear, I believe a shingle must have been blown off. Bring the bucket over here, darling.
Gee, look at the puddle!
Yes, we'll need the mop.
I'll do it.
Thank you, dear. I can see where you're going to be a big help around here. Now, let's see. I wonder if we could stop it with these rags.
Here, let me hold the light.
Thank you. It's not so dark, though, once your eyes get used to it.
Is that all right?
Fine. I just wish now I'd let them put a light up here when they wired the house. It didn't seem worth it at the time. Never use this attic anymore. There. That ought to work. At least until I can get a man to come and look at it.
It wasn't much of a puddle.
No. I guess it ran down all the way through the cracks in the floor. It's a good thing you came, though, darling. If we hadn't opened up that room for you, goodness knows when we would have discovered that leak. Why, the whole house might have been washed away.
You think so? The whole house?
Well, part of it, anyways.
Oh, I think it's starting again.
Oh, yes. Is there another rag in there, darling?
I gave them all to you. Shall I go down and get some more?
Maybe you better. Look in the kitchen closet. Oh, no. I think your Aunt Hannah's taken them all out to the hen house. Do you remember where the door is to the cellar stairs?
Sure. Right by the stove.
That's right. Well, there's a box right at the head of the stairs with some rags in it. I better bring an armful.
Okay.
I might as well go down with her, Miss Louise. I really should get started back.
Oh, no. Can't you stay to dinner?
I'm sorry, but it's a long drive, and with all this rain...
Well, I'll come down with you.
And let the house get washed away?
No need to come down. I can find my way. Besides, you'd only have to come back up again.
Well, it doesn't seem a very nice thing to do.
I don't mind at all, really.
Well, it's been a great pleasure meeting you, Mrs. Clayton. I hope we'll see you again real soon.
You will, I promise. Now, if there's anything... Alice, dear, why don't you run on ahead? I'll be down in just a minute.
Okay, but don't go without saying goodbye to me.
I wouldn't dream of it. Just a few minutes, dear. I want to speak to your Aunt Louise.
Okay.
I guess we don't need this anymore. Miss Louise, I just thought, if you had any further questions...
Oh, I don't think so. She's a lovely little girl.
Yes, she is. I grew quite fond of her in the few days she spent with me. Frankly, I'd like to have kept her. Still, her place is here, with what family she has left. Pardon me, that doesn't sound quite like I meant it.
It's true. This isn't a very exciting home for her. Off in the country with two old ladies. Poor little thing. It's hard to lose one's parents anytime. But so young, and both at once like that.
Oh, I believe it's starting again.
It is, a little.
One question, Miss Louise. Your sister, Miss...
Hannah?
Yes. I didn't get a chance to talk with her very much, but I just wonder...
Oh, don't worry. Hannah's all right. Strange, yes, has been most her life, but quite all right. As a matter of fact, her hen house and chickens are almost an obsession with her. Spends most of her time with them, but now, having Alice here, I think it will do us both good.
I'm sure it will. Well, if there's any question, you know how to get in touch with me.
Yes, I have the number of the social agency.
And I'll try to get back sometime in the next few weeks. There's bound to be a period of readjustment, and I may be able to help. Most important, remember, I want to.
Thank you. Oh, it seems so silly to say goodbye to you in the attic.
Well, to tell the truth, it is the first time.
Here, you better take the light.
You're sure you don't need it?
Not anymore. Matter of fact, it seems a bit brighter. Maybe it's going to clear at last.
I certainly hope so. Well, goodbye.
Goodbye, Mrs. Clayton. And thank you for all your kindness.
It's a pleasure. Goodbye.
Louise goes back to the leak, adjusting the rags. Louise pays no attention to the music at first. After a moment, she turns, almost hearing the tune, but not quite. Finally, she shrugs and turns back to the leak. Silently, Hannah appears at the stairwell.
Oh, hello, dear. Did you see Mrs. Clayton?
I hid. One of the hens got very wet. I dried her with a towel.
That's nice.
Hannah stands near the chest nervously, as if on guard.
What are you doing up here?
Oh, there's a bad leak, really bad. I'm afraid the ceiling paper downstairs is ruined. I'll have to call old Mr. Test as soon as this rain lets up.
I hate the rain, Louise. Did I ever tell you that? I hate the rain.
Oh, I guess a lot of people do. Except for farmers, of course. Father used to pray for rain this time of year.
Father prayed a lot.
Yes, he did. And after all the crops got planted, he always said, "Now it's up to the plenties. Plenty of sun, plenty of rain, and plenty of praying." Remember?
Yes. Now it's up to the plenties. I heard something. Somebody's downstairs.
Of course, dear. It's Alice. She's saying goodbye to Mrs. Clayton.
Alice.
Yes, dear. Sue's little girl. She's come to live with us, you remember.
Little girl? Lydia? Lydia's coming?
No, dear. Alice, our little niece. She's all alone now that Sue's gone, and she's going to live here.
No! I hate children!
No, you don't, dear. And certainly not Alice. She's so very sweet, and we're going to make her feel at home and happy with us. Aren't we? Aren't we, Hannah?
Yes.
And we mustn't forget. Promise?
I promise. Lydia isn't coming.
No, dear. Not this time.
You're sure?
I'm sure.
She could get away from those gypsies if she wanted to. She could! The gypsies did take her away, you know, Louise.
Yes, dear. I know, but that was many years ago. You must try and forget about Lydia. Oh, look, Hannah. here's my old slate. Remember?
Gypsies are no good. They should all be locked up. They should have to sit and look at the rain. That's what, all day long, just look at the rain.
Here's the rags, Aunt Louise.
Thank you, darling, but I don't think we're going to need them after all. See, it's not dripping at all. Did Mrs. Clayton get off all right?
Uh-huh.
She's very nice, and she's promised to come back and see us again real soon. Oh, just put them down any place. Mercy, just look at this attic. Someday we're going to have to come up here and clean this place out.
Unnoticed, Hannah rises, tense and alert.
Oh, what a shame. Your first day here has to be so dismal.
Oh, I don't mind.
Cooped up here with two old women? But there are several little girls in the neighborhood. Rainy days won't be so bad if there's someone to play with.
I like this place. I never saw an attic before.
Haven't seen it myself for a good many years. We never come up here. First time this roof's ever given us any trouble. Well, it's old, like some of the rest of us.
You're not Lydia. Are you?
Me?
You are Lydia.
Now, Hannah, please. This is Alice, our niece, Alice.
Oh, but she might be Lydia. She might be disguised.
Hannah, here. Why don't you take this bucket down and empty it? We'll stay a few minutes and make sure the leak doesn't start again. Go on now.
Well, all right. But she might be. She just might be.
We'll be down in a little while. Go on now, dear. She's tired. So tired.
Louise turns and sees Alice at her old slate.
That used to be mine, many years ago. I haven't seen it for goodness knows how long.
It's nice. It's an awful big house, isn't it?
Yes, too big. 10 bedrooms, cellar, attic, and closets we haven't used in 20 years.
Gee!
But we gave you the nicest room, for your very own. Lots of windows, and in the winter, the warmest room in the house. I just hope it isn't the wettest. Yes, I guess that's going to hold.
Aunt Louise?
Yes?
Why doesn't Aunt Hannah like me?
Oh, my dear, I'm so sorry. She does, but didn't your mother ever tell you that your Aunt Hannah is a little different from other people?
Is she? No, Mummy never said anything.
I'm so used to it, I guess, but ever since she was a little girl, she's been, well, she's been like something touched by an early frost.
She got frostbitten?
Not exactly, dear, but well, your Aunt Hannah is a little removed from the rest of the world.
Removed?
She had a shock, and it affected her very, very much.
What kind of shock?
Well, there was another little girl named Lydia, who was her very best friend. A pretty little girl, just about your age. In fact, she looked something like you.
Like me?
Except that she always wore a big hair ribbon tied on a bow on top of her head. Yes, I remember.
But what happened? Tell me, Aunt Louise.
Well, one day, Lydia disappeared.
Did the gypsies take her?
We don't know for sure. Never really knew. The sheriff combed the countryside, arrested 3 or 4 gypsy men, but they all insisted they didn't know anything about it.
Gee!
And ever since then, your Aunt Hannah has been a little removed. But she really likes you very much, in spite of anything she might say, so you mustn't be upset. Mustn't be unhappy. All right?
Sure.
Well, I guess it is going to be all right. Shall we go down and start thinking about our dinner? As soon as this weather lets up, we'll go out and see Aunt Hannah's chickens.
A trance-like look spreads over Alice's face. She sits very still, eyes glazed, and her lips begin to mouth silent words. Gradually, the words become audible.
The dolly in the blue lace dress, blue lace dress, blue lace dress, the dolly in the blue lace dress.
What's that, dear?
The dolly in the blue lace dress.
Doll in the... aren't those new words to London Bridge? Alice! Alice, dear, what is it?
What? Oh! Why, there's a dolly in a blue lace dress.
I don't understand.
I know there is one. Someplace, Aunt Louise. I have to find it. I have to.
Where did you get this idea all of a sudden?
I don't know. All I know is there's a doll someplace in a blue lace dress, and I'm supposed to find it.
Oh, I guess your mother must have mentioned this doll, but... what's the matter?
The attic. It's here in the attic.
Of course. How silly of me. There must be all kinds of things up here. Games, dolls, goodness knows what all.
From when you were a little girl?
Yes. Now, why don't we see what we can dig out? Everything was packed away so long ago. Heaven knows where anything is, but whatever you can find, you're welcome to.
The doll in the blue lace dress.
Hannah appears at the stairwell, face drawn, hands working.
As a matter of fact, your Aunt Hannah would know much more about that than I would. I was the tomboy, played outdoors, but your Aunt Hannah used to play up here days on end until... Why, Hannah, what is it?
Nothing.
You're white as a ghost. What's wrong?
Nothing. Nothing.
You're shaking. You've got a chill. You better lie down.
I'm all right. Let me alone.
Been going out to the hen house too much and all this rain.
Get rid of her, please. Get rid of her. I don't want
Stop
her to.
Stop it,
please.
Hannah. You weren't ill. I'd be very
provoked. Send her away. Make her go away, please.
Hannah, you've never acted this way before. What is it?
She pretends to be Lydia. She makes me frightened.
No, dear. Such a sweet little girl. You can't.
I do mean it. I hate her. I hate her.
Hannah, stop it this minute. Come now. I'm going to put you to bed and I'm going to call Dr. Sawyer. I won't have any more of this. Come along. Yes, dear?
Can I stay up here?
No!
Oh, do be quiet, Hannah. Of course you can, darling, and I'll be back a little later. And you mustn't be upset, dear. Remember what I told you.
She's removed.
Yes. Come, Hannah. You'll feel better lying down. Much better.
No. She makes me frightened. Make her go away. Make her go away.
Alice, left alone, becomes engrossed in exploring. Silently, a fragile, very pale, extremely pretty 12-year-old girl appears just behind the chest, magically. She wears a simple play dress of 50 years ago, with a large hair ribbon tied in a bow on top of her head. Alice is not aware of her until she speaks.
Hello.
Why, hello. Who are you?
Lydia, of course. Who are you?
I'm Alice, but I didn't hear you come up. Where did you come from?
Oh, I play here all the time. That's a nice carriage, isn't it?
Alice suddenly realizes that she is standing by an old doll carriage.
Why, yes. I guess you could play with it.
I'd like that. I've been alone for so long.
That's a very pretty dress.
Thank you.
Did you say your name was Lydia?
Yes. Why?
Nothing, I guess. Except Aunt Louise told me about a little girl named Lydia. The gypsies took her.
Mercy, yes. I know about that.
Did Aunt Louise tell you too?
Mercy, no. But I know about it. I know lots of things.
You talk funny.
So do you.
I'm looking for the doll in the blue lace dress.
It's in that box.
Swell! Woo! It's dusty.
No one's been up here for years and years.
Except you, you mean?
Except me, but I've been here for ever so long.
Funny. Aunt Louise didn't tell me you were coming up here.
She doesn't know it.
You mean you just came without them knowing?
Mercy no, your Aunt Hannah knows.
Oh, that's all right then. Oh, look! Isn't that the sweetest thing?
Alice holds up an old-fashioned doll in a blue lace dress.
I bet she was Aunt Louise's when she was a little girl.
No, she was Hannah's.
I never saw such beautiful clothes on a doll.
Look around her neck, under the dress.
Where?
In front, there's a button at the top.
Alice sits on the chest, finds the button, and discovers a key on a string around the doll's neck.
Why, it's a key!
Yes, yes!
Can you imagine? Do you know what it opens?
Take it off and I'll show you.
It's a funny place for a key.
It's a dandy place to hide it. Now, open the chest.
Which one?
The one you're sitting on.
This one?
Yes.
You're sure it's all right?
Of course. It hasn't been opened for such a long time. Nearly 50 years. It's got to be opened. It's got to be.
I think I'd better wait and ask Aunt Louise.
No. Open it now. Please. Please.
Why don't you open it?
I can't. Go on, please.
Well, Aunt Louise did say, I guess it's all right.
Hurry, please hurry.
It sticks. I guess it's rusty. If I could only...
Hannah suddenly appears at the stairwell as, simultaneously, Lydia disappears.
What are you doing, Alice?
Oh, Aunt Hannah, you scared me.
What are you doing there?
I was going to open this box. I found the key.
You found the key?
Yes. And Lydia said this was the box.
Lydia? What did you say?
Yes, Lydia, she... That's funny. Lydia? Where are you? Lydia? We were going to play. Maybe she's hiding. Lydia? Are we supposed to hunt for you? What do you think, Aunt Hannah? Shall we try to find her?
No. No, I have a better idea. We'll hide from her. Then when she comes out, she won't know where to find us. Isn't that a fine idea?
Swell! This is fun. Now, let's see. Where shall I hide?
Alice! I know a wonderful place.
Where?
Right here.
Hannah's hand nervously caresses the chest.
You could get inside and I'd lock you in and take the key and she'd never find you.
Well, no. I think I'd rather...
And the chest is thick. You could pound and pound and she'd never hear you.
But why should I pound if I'm hiding from her?
No, you wouldn't, of course. But if she were to go away and you wanted to get her back, she wouldn't hear you pounding. And after a while, you'd stop. Come along, Alice. This is the place to hide.
No, I don't want to hide in there.
I'll unlock it for you.
No. I don't want to play anymore.
Of course you do. Come along now.
No! Lydia, come out. We're not playing anymore.
Stand still. You're going into that box.
I'm not. What's the matter with you anyhow? Get away. Lydia, Aunt Louise.
Alice has backed against the pile of boxes, trapping herself completely. Her scream is stifled as Hannah claps a hand over her mouth, grabs her, and drags her toward the chest.
Now we'll see if you'll do any more prying. You'll stay in here until I want to let you out. Come on now! I won't have any silly children around this house. I hate children!
She has difficulty holding Alice while unlocking the chest. Her hand is momentarily removed from Alice's mouth as she turns the key in the lock. Alice screams.
Aunt Louise!
But she is quickly muffled.
Now then!
Hannah releases Alice's mouth to raise the lid. Again, Alice screams.
Help!
But as soon as Hannah lifts the lid, Lydia stands up in the box.
Hello, Hannah.
Lydia, it's you.
Hannah releases Alice, who runs through the stairwell screaming.
Aunt Louise! Aunt Louise!
It is you, isn't it, Lydia?
Yes, Hannah. I've waited a long time for you to let me out. Nearly 50 years.
And you're not dead. You're alive?
Well, let's just say I'm free.
Yes. Oh, I must tell Louise. I must tell Louise. Now I can tell.
Hannah? Hannah, what is it? Alice came screaming down the stairs as if...
As Louise appears, Lydia slowly sinks down into the chest, closing the lid.
It's Lydia. She's all right. I didn't kill her after all. I didn't kill her.
What are you saying?
The gypsy's saying that for Louise. I made that up. I lied. That day, the day she disappeared, we were playing up here and I locked her in the box. And when I went back, I thought she was dead and I...
Who was dead?
Lydia. So I was frightened. I didn't mean it, Louise. I was frightened. And I locked the box again and hid the key and said the gypsies took her, but they didn't. She was in the box, but it's all right now, Louise. She's alive.
But that was 50 years ago.
Yes, but she's all right. It's a miracle. Look, come and see.
Hannah drags her sister to the chest and raises the lid.
I didn't kill her. She's... No. Oh, no, Lydia!
Hannah turns, sobbing, and buries her head against Louise. Louise looks down and is horrified. Slowly, she reaches down into the chest and brings out a large hair ribbon tied in a bow.
Oh, Hannah. No wonder.
She drops the hair ribbon back into the chest and closes the lid. Alice has crept back up and stands, fascinated.
It's all right, Hannah. It's all right.
I'm glad you know, Louise. I'm glad. It's been so long. So long.
Yes, Hannah.
And now, when they take me away, and I know they must take me away, you won't be alone. You'll have Alice.
Louise stands with one arm around Hannah and places the other around Alice.
Dear little Alice.
Dog! That was just great, Cora. That was great, all of you. Thanks, all of you. Let's bring our Baylor sisters down here again and hear from our sponsors once more.
Gosh, Barb! What's that in your pan?
What do you mean, Janice?
That grease left over in your pan. Yuck! You can't be cooking with crummy stuff.
Well, what should we do then?
Get Miro! It cleans your pots and pans in no time!
But what if I scratch them? I'd be ruining my mom's old pans.
No need to flip your wig. Miro's ultra-smooth formula will leave them sparkling as if they're brand new. No scratches to even think about at all.
Really? That's a miracle. Now I can cook all the amazing meals I want for my family with my clean pots and pans.
Pans and pots and grease salons, you gotta go modern, Miro's for you.
Marilyn's right. Miro really is the best. You know, before my husband was drafted, we'd make a day out of washing the dishes. We just had so much fun washing them together and throwing the soap suds at each other. Nowadays, of course, I wash them alone, but with Miro dish soap, I feel a little bit less lonely. Thanks, Miro, for being our sponsor tonight.
Do you hear that? That's the sound of sweet satisfaction and bliss.
That's right! Coca-Cola is guaranteed to not only quench your thirst, but to also provide a delicious flavor in the process.
Who needs flavorless water when you have a nice cold Coke in the fridge?
Feeling tired after a long day at work? Up your moxie and grab a Coke.
It's your daily pick-me-up.
Coca-Cola right now. You know, Coca-Cola was my husband's favorite drink. Sometimes I use empty Coca-Cola bottles as flower vases just to remind myself of him. Well, this brings us to the close of our show and the chance for us to do what we do every Saturday night. Say a little something special to the men we miss the most. It's been real hard here at home while our men have been fighting overseas. And each one of us here at Dash Radio Hour has at least one loved one who is away from Boston. We like to take just a few moments each week to send our love to them and let them know how brave we think they are and how proud we are of them. I'll start us off. I'd like to send lots of love to my dear husband, Jeremy, who is serving as a corporal in the Air Force. The kids and I miss you very much.
My message is to Private Alistair Wood of the Army's 27th Infantry. Hey, Allie, it's your big sister. Hope you're doing right all overseas. Mom and Dad miss you very much, and they can't wait for you to return home. I love you, and keep going strong.
This is Marilyn McGrain. Peter, dear, it's your wife, Marilyn. I wanted to tell you that I love you very much, and your children and I are missing you greatly from Boston. I pray unconditionally for your return, and God tells me you are healthy.
This is Sarah Lynn Rogerson. I would like to give a shout out to my love, Henry, who is a first lieutenant in the 11th Airborne Division in the United States Air Corps. Henry, please don't die. May God bring you safely back to me and our dear children. Sending you all my love.
This is Cora Young, sending all my love to France for my husband, Jack. It's lonely here at home without you.
This is Babs Bennett sending all my love to my baby brother, Connor, stationed in France. Mom, Sam, and I miss you so, so much. And you better stay safe and come back home soon or I'm sailing over there myself.
Hi, everyone. This is Francis Buck, and I just want to send some love to my best friend, James Harper, who's serving in the Navy. Boston misses you.
This is Virginia James, and I'd like to send some love to my amazing husband, Captain Theodore James, and my two amazing brothers, Charles and Philip Johnson. I miss you all so very much. Now please come home to me.
Hey everyone, this is Betty Sue Johnson. I want to let Stephen Wood, my wonderful fiance, know that I received his last letter and am eagerly awaiting his return home. He is the head cook in the Navy navigation mess aboard the USS Enterprise CV-6. If you hear this, know that I love you and miss you more than words can express.
Hiya, Shirley here. This week I'd like to give a wonderful shout out to my boyfriend Leo, fighting off in the Navy. I miss ya, hope to see you at home soon.
Hello everyone, my name is Evelyn Hawks. I have a couple of loved ones I want to give a shout out to. To my husband, Harold Hawks, who is serving in the U.S. Navy as a doctor, and to my father, Peter Davis, who is serving in the U.S. Air Force. I can't wait for you two to meet my two wonderful twin girls, Frances and Maxine. I miss you. Come back safe and sound.
This is Hazel Pruitt, and I want to send all my love to my fiancé, Lieutenant Philip Barnes, who's with 108th Division overseas. Come home soon. I miss you so much.
Thanks, ladies. Gee, that was sure something. I hope all your soldiers and sailors stay safe. All right, friends, we've come to the end of our time together. Before we go, I'd like to thank our wonderful sponsors, Dristan Cold Medicine, Kirkman Borax Soap, Miro Dish Soap, and Coca-Cola. All right, So, from the bottom of my heart, I wish you farewell. It's been such a joy to spend this time together tonight. We sure love our time with you, and we hope you love your time with us. So, from the Baylor sisters, Marilyn, Carolyn, and Sarah Lynn, from Evelyn and Hazel over at our sound effects table, from all our friends of the Dash Vaudeville troupe, and from me, Veronica Day, I wish you all good night and adieu until next week.